You guys, and welcome to Destiny 2, where today we're back with week 5. I know this is normally my Thursday video, however, I needed to take the time to really... I've had some personal stuff going on, so I needed a bit of a break from this, as well as my own work, personal work, plus my podcast over at Stasis Chat. So, and I've been ill, so there's been a lot going on. If I sound a bit weird this week, that's because I still haven't fully recovered. So yeah, let's get into week 5, where we need to go to the helm again. So let's go speak to the Starchart.
Sent a message to Aramis. She invoked a ritual from the old crew's words with empty hands. It is a type of parley where no violence is permitted. Ido believes Aramis will follow the rules of her people. I am not so trusting. Should Aramis accept, I would ask that you accompany us. In the meantime, continue the fight. This may be a ploy, and we must not be fooled. I hope that she ignores Ido's request, but if she does not, know this. Aramis does nothing that is not to her benefit. A word can do more damage than a blade, and Aramis is skilled at wielding both.
That's why she brought a knife to a gunfight. Right, so hey, instantly did the 50 champions. Right, so I need to bring up my quests, the captain's atlas. I'm gonna pick rotating expedition armor map, and obviously I'm gonna use the skiff blades. Come bro.
Their return to this place in the presence of other sheep spawn. Where is your pride, Mithrax?
Pride is a sickness that killed the younger Mithrax, as it will kill you in time.
You claim piety, even as you plunder.
It's not him plundering, and it's for the greater good. The greater good. We'll go now. Complete this. Ooh, the bully. The bully. I don't trust this with Aramis one bit. Up. Come on, let's go get the bully. Why do I feel like I'm doing a different one? I feel like I've done this before. So I'm quite... confused as to where come on, you're a bully. Fight me like one. I regret not having this one. Oh, my wallop. That would have gone so much easier if I had my warlock. Come on, boys and girls. Because you fell. What I didn't need is exploders in a small space. You can heal. Come on, Mr. Disappearing Man. That was so, so much easier than I was expecting. You pee off. I need to get back there. Cutscene. Maybe not a cutscene. I was expecting a cutscene with the way that went.
You taught me to honor Eliksni tradition. Aramis Scale agreed to parley. You cannot lose faith in the old ways now.
This is a mistake, Ido. Aramis listens to one voice only, and it is not ours.
I may draw power from the voice in the darkness. But I am an Eliksni Kel, and I fight for the liberation of our people.
A true Kel serves their house. You serve only the witness.
And who do you serve? I agreed to meet with Eliksni, not a light bearer.
The Guardian is here for your protection.
Aramis Kel, a scribe of House of Light, I feel compelled to tell you. There is another force searching for these relics. I see. And who are these new meddlers exactly?
One of many you have wronged, perhaps.
We did not identify the force, but they dispatched your associates with ease. We have in them a common enemy. We have always had a common enemy. Abandon your pathetic attempts to appease your oppressors. Join me. Together we'll use these relics to achieve true freedom for the Eliksni.
No. The relics pose too great a threat. They cannot fall to warmongers like you.
None know of their destructive power better than you. What do you mean?
It was centuries ago. I am no longer that person.
No, you are the same as ever. I want to know the truth. Will I have to hear it from her? Centuries ago, when the Eliksni first came to this system, when your father was just a hatchling, our people had nothing. So, when they discovered Nezarek, disciple of the Witness, entombed in the Lunar Pyramid, they harvested its dark power for themselves, and for the future of our people. these relics, and its power ensnared him. He sought more, no matter the cost. But the more his crew had, the less they shared. That became the way of things. Eliksni turned against Eliksni, and friend turned against friend. Over time, the relics of Nezarek were separated and scattered across the galaxy. Their influence faded, but the stains of their power endure. Nezarek's fled from the butchery he was born into. He claims he has changed and now lives a life of piety. But no matter how he tries to bury his past with selfish displays of generosity and scraps of stolen wisdom, Nezarek will always be a liar, a thief, and a killer.
Here we go. Neutral asteroid. Oh dear. I know. Why'd you keep doing this? You keep giving me a heart attack.
Truth is difficult, but the sharpest pain comes from the fact that he didn't tell me earlier. I was aware he had a past, but in a way, Aramis showed me who my father is today. Who he sees when he looks at me. He must think I am unable to understand, or he doesn't care whether or not I do. I am either underestimated or dismissed. Take only one lesson from this. My own father does not want me to know him. My priorities have not changed. We must stop Aramis from claiming the relics of Nezarek. I will not place my own feelings above our mission. I will not become the hypocrite that my father is.
I know. He loves you. He just... I don't know how to put it.
Shall we make a deal?
I'll go with this, Emerald.
You may go.
And there we go. So, yeah, I know this one, I'm not sure if this one will be up a tad late because of work, me being ill. However, I do hope to have this all sorted and be back on regular scheduling next week. However, I can't guarantee that, which, because of my health. Like I said, the camera's gone because of video lip sync is completely out, and I am trying to get everything sorted. I will probably come up with a video sooner rather than later explaining some stuff, but I think for now, it's down to when this video. So remember, as always, guys, stay awesome.